I am Dr. Sita Jayalakshmi. I am working as neurologist at Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences, Secunderabad. And my special area of interest is epilepsy. I am associated with epilepsy and epilepsy surgery for the past more than 15 years. So we will briefly discuss about the important aspects of epilepsy, which is important for the public and also for the persons who are having epilepsy. Epilepsy is a very common neurological condition. And epilepsy affects 1 in 100. And not only that, 10% of the children will have at least one seizure in life. So once a person has epilepsy, it's important, he is very much interested to know what to be done, what not to be done, how to manage the epilepsy, and what is the rest of the life for him about the career, marriage. So there will be so many questions. So the first thing is coming to the incidence and prevalence of epilepsy. As I already said, epilepsy affects 1 in 100, but the incidence of epilepsy is about 3 to 4 in 1,000 persons. Not only that, epilepsy affects frequently children, that is, who are below the age of 2 years, and also elderly, more than the rest of the ages. It can occur at any age, but more importantly, it is more common in children as well as elderly, and the causes of epilepsy are different according to the age. Usually, below the age of 2 years, the commonest cause of epilepsy is called hypoxic ischemic damage to the brain. That is, at the time of the birth, if the circulation to the brain is reduced, either because of some issues during the delivery or delivery being occurring at home, if the child does not cry immediately after the birth. So this is one of the important preventable causes of epilepsy, and hence very important that everybody should take care not only during pregnancy, delivery, and also immediate post-delivery, both by the patient as well as the doctor. In addition to that, there are other causes in this age, which are usually because of reduced calcium or reduced glucose immediately after the birth. That's why if the baby does not take mother's milk, it's very important that the baby should be fed from the day one with the glucose solution or others as advised by the pediatrician, so that we can prevent this, again, neonatal hypoglycemia, which is also an important cause for a preventable epilepsy. And after this, that is after the age of 2 years, up to 12 years, there are other important causes for the epilepsy. The most important thing in this is something called developmental abnormalities of the brain, that is malformation of the development of the brain. Again, in addition to this, there are other causes like slow growing tumors, or sometimes some scars can occur. Not only this, one of the important cause is neurocysticercosis in children. This is usually because of not having a good hygiene, or it spreads from the water which is contaminated, or from the fresh vegetables which are not cleaned properly. Again, this is a preventable cause of epilepsy, because in this what happens is small worms which are present in the intestine will go to the brain through the circulation and will cause this cysticercosis infection, which will cause again seizures. And once it subsides, sometimes it can leave a calcification, that is, which is again something like a scar, which can be responsible for epilepsy throughout the rest of the life. So one has to really prevent this, as it is a preventable cause. And again, in addition to this, children can have something called absence epilepsy. In this, what happens is the child suddenly stops doing what the child is doing, and they may not be aware, and these can happen sometimes 20 to 100 times in a day, and which can be, they can go unnoticed. But when it is noticed, it's important that it should be treated. And in adolescence, the most important cause is something called juvenile myoclonic epilepsy, which is associated with not only fits like a jerking of limbs, and also some jerks in the body, which are usually precipitated by lack of sleep or concentration. And once you come across the age of 30 years, again, the causes are different. Usually, they are related to possibly alcohol or alcohol withdrawal, or sometimes tumors in the brain. Most important is, again, road traffic accidents, which can cause trauma. And this is also, the trauma is one of the important preventable causes of epilepsy. If you see in India, there are, every second, there are at least one accident occurs, which can lead to head injury. And one can prevent this by wearing helmets and other precautions which should be followed according to the traffic rules. And then it is also, the head injury is one of the preventable causes of epilepsy. And after the age of 40 years, again, tumors, take the as the important cause. And after the age of 60 years, in addition to tumors, one can have usually something related to tumors in the brain, like or secondary tumors with a primary somewhere, and also again reduction in the sodium, calcium. Now, and in addition to that, they can have some memory disturbances again associated with epilepsy. So, after the causes of epilepsy, how do we investigate epilepsy? Epilepsy, the basic two investigations are doing an EEG and second one is doing a scan for the brain. Usually MRI brain gives more information than the CT scan, that's why doctors most of the time do MRI, but if it is an emergency, one can go for a CT scan. EEG usually will help us to decide what is the type of epilepsy and decide what drug should be given to the person. And once the diagnosis of epilepsy is made, actually most of us can get a single fit in life, but single fit is not equal to epilepsy. So, a person should get at least two or more fits without any unprovoked, that means without any fever or metabolic disturbances. So, once epilepsy is confirmed, once these investigations are done, it will sometimes MRI can be normal as seen in 30% of the persons who have epilepsy. In 70%, MRI can show something abnormal. So, based on this, the drug treatment is decided. Once you start the treatment, there are so many anti-epileptic drugs are available. So, all drugs are equally good or bad, because the determination of which drug to be used in a person is decided by the type of epilepsy, the person's weight, and also whether he has any associated anxiety features or depressive features, and the drug will be decided by the neurologist. Once you give this medicine, out of 100, 70 will be well controlled on medications. Usually with a single drug or sometimes a maximum of two medications, 70% of the people with epilepsy will be controlled. The problem comes is when the rest of the 30% are not well controlled. So, but it is not only taking the drug, there are many do's and don'ts when you are managing epilepsy. So, the most important are, one has to eat on time and sleep on time, because lack of sleep is an important factor for precipitation of seizures. Missing a drug, that is missing the drug for epilepsy, is an important cause. In addition to this, one should take precautions, like you should avoid driving as well as swimming, and also the other works which can cause injury to the person if you get a fit during that time. In addition to that, if somebody gets a fit, all of us should not run away. That is what happens in public. We should always have take care of the person who falls with epilepsy, especially in the schools. The teachers and the friends of the children should know how to manage. It's nothing difficult. During the fit, no one should touch the person. Immediately once the fit is over, just turn him to one side and make the clothes loose so that he is able to breathe well. And not only that, immediately we can call the doctor if the fit is lasting for more than 5 minutes. Normally a fit lasts for 30 seconds to 1 minute. And for the lay public who do not know how to identify a fit, usually most of us know that during the fit means there is a jerking of the hand and legs. Not only that, sometimes it can be just like staring with loss of awareness of the surroundings. Sometimes there can be only eye blinking. Sometimes they may get jerks in the body. Sometimes they do some movements like automatisms, means they go on movements like chewing and also moving of the hands with unawareness. When you ask the person, he says, I did not do anything or I am not aware of that. So, if these features are there, definitely bring to the attention of the parents and also to the doctor, so that he will be investigated and the required treatment will be given. So, as I already said, 30% of the people may not be well controlled with the medication. So, these are the people who should go to specialized centers, because epilepsy surgery is one of the important options for a person whose epilepsy is not well controlled in spite of using the medications, at least for 6 months in children and 2 years in adults. So, once you cross this period of 2 years and still fits are not well controlled, you should go to the doctor for the best management, that is to the specialized centers. What usually we do in these centers is, we do a detailed video EEG, we do advanced testing like a 3 Tesla MRI, and also an SPECT and PET. All these are important mainly to decide from where the epileptic focus is coming. So, once this epileptic focus is identified clearly, then that focus will be operated and removed. And sometimes, so in these cases, the success of epilepsy surgery varies somewhere from 60% to 80%, depending on the type of the epilepsy. And the risk of epilepsy surgery is definitely less than 0.5%. If you take the overall risk of epilepsy throughout the life, it is much more than the risk of epilepsy surgery. And hence, epilepsy surgery is a very good option for somebody to consider if it is affecting the quality of life of the person. And after this, epilepsy and driving, one should not drive once the epilepsy is active. One can drive only if the seizures are well controlled for 2 years, that too if the person is an epilepsy. Then coming to the epilepsy and marriage, there is no restriction for people to marry. All the epilepsies are not genetic, and you can always take the help of the doctors to decide. And all the persons with epilepsy can marry normally and live like any other normal person. And in women with epilepsy also, it's not a challenge. They also should be very proactive and positive about thinking of this. And they will be given the drugs which are safe during pregnancy. And one should take, and also they can have children like any other normal person. And can have, and there is, as very few epilepsies are genetic, there is no rule that all the children will develop epilepsy. So finally, the message is that people who have epilepsy should not take this as a means as a some difficulty or a major problem in the life. They should have a control on epilepsy and not the other way. And finally, live like any other normal person with a positive attitude.